Hello all, I welcome you to UET eSectiona program. This lecture is for Bachelors of Architecture students of third semester for the subject Climatology with subject code 18 ERC 3.3. In this lecture, I am going to talk about the climatic zones of India, the classification of climatic zones of India, and what are the characteristics of those climatic zones in India. Okay. As we know, India is one of the largest populated, in fact it is the second largest populated country in the world. It is spread over an area of approximately 3.27 million square kilometers. So it is one of the largest, it is spread across a very large area. And since it belongs to tropical climates, it is one of the tropical, you can also say it is one of the tropical country. It also exhibits some kind of, let's say, cold and dry and cold and humid kind of climatic zones also. So, as we can see, this is a map that has been produced by NBC, that is National Building Code, and also ECBC, that is Energy Conservation Building Code. Now, these organizations have made the classification based on the different characteristics of different climatic zones. Okay, now we can see that in this there is mainly classified into five climates, that is hot, dry, hot and dry, you can call it as hot and dry, warm and humid, composite, temperate and cold climates. So hot and dry, warm and humid, composite, temperate and cold climate. Okay. Major part of the India is comprises of mainly three climates, that is hot and dry, warm, humid and composite. There are some areas which are having temperate, or it is also called as moderate or temperate, and some areas which you can say it is cold. Now cold, if you consider the northern region of India, that is for the states of Jammu, Kashmir, Ladakh, and also some of the northeastern states to the northern, that is along the Himalayas, is considered as cold. There are some areas also like Mount Abu here in Rajasthan, and some regions like, let's say, Ooty or Kodaikanal. So these regions also fall into the climate of, let's say, cold. Okay. But whereas when we see the first the thing classification in this legend, that is hot dry climates, the major city, major states you can say is Rajasthan, and it is having the east of Gujarat, and also a partly Madhya Pradesh, a bigger chunk of you can say Maharashtra, and also some of the northern portion of Karnataka is included into this hot dry climate. Okay, when we say warm humid climate, you can see again, the major along the you can see along the coast, that is east coast and west coast of India, and also most of the northeastern states belong to this warm humid climate. Okay, so and also some part of Gujarat, basically along the east coast and also along the you can say west coast. Okay, so this is east coast, which has let's say West Bengal, Orissa, okay, major portion of Tamil Nadu. So this all belongs to the eastern coast, and Karnataka, Kerala, okay, so, Maharashtra, Goa, Diu Daman, okay, and some of the eastern part of western part of Gujarat will also fall into this category, that is warm humid climate. Okay. And composite, the central India is basically categorized into the composite climate, where it exhibits some of the characters of let's say hot, dry and also humid. Okay. Now the humidity is again because of a lot of rivers that are flowing in this region, like Ganga, Brahmaputra and these things, and also it is having a lot of relative humidity in this area. During monsoon, you can say, but summers it is very dry, so that is why it is exhibiting both the characters of, let's say, hot and dry and warm and humid. So that is why this can be classified into composite. Okay. Now temperate is some places like, let's say, Bangalore, okay, Pune, where there is not much of variations in climatic or diurnal variations, you can say. So then it can be, or it is in a very comfort zone. So these climates are classified as temperate. Okay, it is also considered, considered as moderate or temperate. Okay, so these are the majorly, you can say, the fly climatic classifications of India. Okay, now on the right also you can see the relationship. This classification is again mainly based on you can say the temperature and the precipitation or relative humidity. Okay, so there are mainly three factors, you can say, which will constitute a particular or which will give certain characteristics for a particular climatic zone. Okay, now these climate, these characteristics are nothing but, or these elements we can consider them as, first is the temperature, what is the kind of maximum temperature, mean minimum temperature, and what is the monthly temperature, or what is the temperature during summers and during winters or during monsoon. Okay, and also the relative humidity, that is for different seasons, and also what is the relative humidity for the whole year. So based on that, you can see there is this classification that is done. We can see in the x-axis there is temperature, and in the y-axis it is relative humidity. So the blue is nothing but it is representing cold, which is having less temperature, but it is having 0 to 100% of humidity. So this kind of characteristics is shown in, let's say, northern India or along the Himalayas. So that is nothing but, again, cold climate. And yellow, which is again showing the warm humid. Okay, so warm humid we can see here, which is having like a temperature of, let's say, from 30 to approximately up to 50 or more than 50 degrees Celsius. But whereas it is also having the humidity, which is close to the 50 or 55% of humidity to 100% humidity. Okay, so this kind of setting, which is for the mainly coastal climates, for the coastal region, so that it is considered as, you can see here, it is considered as warm and humid. Okay, and similarly, composite climate is exhibiting both of them. So this is again, it is, it might be around the temperature is 30 to 50 degrees Celsius, but it also has sometimes relative humidity, which is from, let's say, from maybe 0% humidity to 100% humidity. So it depends on the seasonal experiences. Okay, in what season people experience different types of temperature and humidity. Okay, so if there is a fluctuation, then also it can be considered as a composite climate. Okay. And major classification, another major classification, you can see hot and dry, which is having very high temperature and low humidity levels. So that is having a temperature of approximately from 35 to 33 through, or this thing to, let's say, 50 degrees Celsius or 50 plus degrees Celsius. And then, but it is having humidity which is less than 50% of humidity, can be considered as hot and dry. Okay. Yeah, so this is again the climatic zone map of India, and showing the different climatic zones. So we follow this zone that is given by National Building Code or ECBC. Okay, so we'll study each zone in detail. So first is hot and dry. So a long stretch of land, so that is what shown in again the map. So it also includes some of the Karnataka, yes, Maharashtra, and you see the main, the cities you can be like, you can identify Jaisalmer, Jodhpur, Solapur. Solapur is very close to the northern Karnataka, that is southern part of Maharashtra, you can see. So that is also exhibiting this hot and dry. Now this hot and dry, you can see the climatic data for this particular climate, where air temperature, that is dry bulb temperature, the temperature might go up to 45 degrees Celsius, which is why it is considered as hot. And during summers also, during winters also, the temperature might be around 30 degrees Celsius. It can have a minimum temperature, that is 5 degrees Celsius during winters. That is at night during winters, the least that is recorded can be up to 5 degrees Celsius. Okay, and you can also see the humidity, which is very less, 25 to 40%. Even sometimes it is less than 25% throughout the year. But mainly this region experiences humidity, very less humidity, so that is why it is classified as hot and dry climate. Okay. And precipitation is also less than 500 mm, that is very less rainfall. And this 500 mm might be again majorly during monsoon, and very less rainfall during other seasons, like other maybe winters or summers. Summers might experience a few convectional rains, but again, there is very less precipitation, that is rainfall, in this area. Okay, so sky is normally clear and blue, where there is very less clouds and these things. And since the sky condition is very clear, so solar radiation is also very direct, strong. You can see a blue sky. And wind velocity is also high, dusty, high-speed dusty winds. That is, the wind here does not carry any kind of humidity or less humidity. So that is why it carries a lot of sand particles or dust particles. So that is why there is a lot of dusty winds. Now, this wind movement can be because of the movement of air from high-pressure area to low-pressure areas. That is to maintain equilibrium in the atmosphere. Okay. Now, vegetation, in this vegetation, as you can see in this image, it's very sparse vegetation and a lot of thorny bushes and trees. Okay. And even the soil is having less organic matter because of very dry weather and this thing. So, there is no scope for much of vegetation growth. Okay. And special characteristics can be, like during certain months, the dust and sandstorms may be very frequent. And even during summers, or you can say, there will be lot of these sandstorms or lot of dust storms. Okay. So the high daytime temperatures, rapid cooling at night may again cause materials to crack and break up. So that is why they try to use materials which is having or they can use materials which can resist both these extreme climate, that is during day and night. There is a vast diurnal change, that is during day and during night. Mainly during, let's say, winters, there is a lot of change in this temperature. So it might develop cracks, or it might lead to the weathering of rocks. And so that is why they have to overcome this particular characteristics. Okay, or they need to treat it. Okay, so we can see some of these buildings that are in this particular climate. They are using different materials. So this is on the left top corner. It is Jodhpur, also considered as blue city in Rajasthan. And the right image is from Jaisalmer, where it is made up of sandstone. And another image is made up of black basalt because of availability of that particular stone. So here we can see they give lot of smaller openings, or they use jelly walls because it is hot throughout the year, and they use thicker walls so that they get a lot of resistance they get good insulation, and they can resist a lot of heat, and also they use thick walls. They try to consider lot of shaded areas for the utility in terms of open areas or frontage of buildings, or for the building, for the walkways and any open activities. So basically, these kind of characteristics are exhibited in the climates of, let's say, hot, dry climates. Okay. So next, you can see warm, humid. So this is mainly the coastal India, and also some part of Gujarat, and also you can say northeastern states, and some of the cities, you can say Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Goa. You can also consider some of the northeastern states to be falling in this category. Okay. Now, warm, humid, as the name itself indicates, it is very hot. That is, you can see temperature might be around 30 to 35 degrees Celsius. Even during winters, it is not very cold. So you can see the minimum temperature of around 20 degrees Celsius, that is minimum at during winter at night. And maximum, let's say during summer, maybe it might be recorded around 35 degrees Celsius. Okay. So the temperature is usually high throughout the year, and it is also having a very high humidity levels of 70 to 90%. So this humidity is mainly because of the Indian Ocean, or you can say Bay of Bengal, or the water bodies that is again flowing in northeastern states. Okay, so there they are having lot of humidity levels because the ocean currents bring lot of moisture into the land. Okay, because this land mass is getting heated up, especially the coastal these things, and it is the hot air as it rises up, it is also creating a low pressure areas. So the air from the surrounding oceans and sea, so they try to maintain equilibrium and they try to flow towards this land, and then causing lot of wind movement also. Okay. So precipitation is very high because there is lot of rains that are that are happening in the throughout the year. So you can say 1,200 to sometimes it goes up to 1,500 mm per year. Okay. So precipitation is usually very high. Sky condition is fairly cloudy. Usually it is very cloudy of 60% to 90%. So solar radiation is also comparatively, you can say, less compared to hotter climate. The intensity of solar radiation is high during summers where there are no clouds or these things, and but during winters or monsoon it is having very cloud cover of, let's say, 90% of cloud cover. Okay. So wind velocity is because of this periodic heat exchange that is happening because of the air movement. So there is some kind of wind velocity which is considered as calm and periodic, but may be strong during the rain, that is during the southwest monsoon winds, or you can say sometimes there might be cyclonic winds, so that are coming. Yes. So I think recently India has experienced on the both coast, on the east coast and west coast, some of the cyclonic winds. Okay. So that is also because of the wind movement. Okay, a lot of wind movement that happens. Okay. So vegetation, since it is warm humid climate, it is very much favorable for vegetation. Vegetation grows very quickly. Not just vegetation, it also helps in the growth of microorganisms like algae, bacteria, virus and these things because it contains lot of moisture, so that becomes easy for survival of lot of microorganisms. And in this weather, there is lot of discomfort as compared to hot and dry because there is lot of humidity in the air and it is also very hot climate. So because of humidity, you are not able to sweat more and it causes some kind of restlessness or uneasy feeling. So that is more during, let's say, summers. Winters are pleasant, but during summers it becomes very horrible, or you can say it is unbearable. Okay. Vegetation grows quickly due to frequent rains. It is having a lot of water, sunlight, and also good temperature. So that helps in lot of growth of vegetation. Special characteristics, organic building materials tend to decay rapidly because of, again, moisture content. Mosquitoes and other insects are abundant. They are found in larger these things and larger diversities also. Thunderstorms are accompanied by frequent air-to-air electrical discharges. The tropical cyclones are hurricanes of wind velocities from 45 to 70 meters per second, so which constitute a serious seasonal hazard. The high salt content of the atmosphere encourages corrosion in coastal areas. So it might corrode a lot of steel structures. Okay. So there is a risk of using exposed steel structures. So they have to have certain particular kind of treatment for those structures, or temporary structures made up of steel. So that is why they need to have certain treatment. Okay. So in this region, basically, they if you see the buildings, so they are again, which is, it is also hot, so they have thicker walls, yes, with good view value, and also it has to have higher R value so that it has lot of resistance towards the heat. But at the same time, they are having lot of openings to have lot of cross ventilation, yes. So along the western ghats and this thing, coastal India, there is a lot of redstone, the laterite stone that is available. So many traditional building, you can see lot of laterite along the Goa or Kerala. And some part of Kerala, they use a lot of wood because of availability of a lot of wood in Western Ghats or even northeastern states, there is a lot of wood. So they use a lot of wood in these areas. And other areas, you can see there is a lot of, because it is having high rainfall, usually they have sloping roofs. And also they have a lot of these open corridor kind of this thing so that they can experience a lot of ventilation, which brings a lot of comfort to the buildings in this region. Okay. So these are the some of the characteristics. I think you can explore more. Coming to the next classification, that is, let's say, moderate. So moderate, the name itself indicates it is very, it is neither too high or neither too less. Even the, it is also considered as, you can call it as moderate or some, it is also called as temperate. Okay. Moderate climate means very, means every climatic feature will be medium, like medium sunlight, medium rainfall, or you can say medium temperature, medium humidity. Okay. Extreme climate is opposite of moderate climate, where you'll have either hot or cold climate. So this is a very moderate climate that is very much very close to the, if you consider the climatic characteristics, it are very close to the human comfort zone. Okay. So in India, this climate can be experienced in Bangalore, Pune, and some of the regions. Okay. So the moderate, you can see the temperature variations. So then the maximum is 34 degrees Celsius and minimum. Maximum, that is during summers, you can say it is around 30 to 34 degrees Celsius for summers. And for winters, the minimum temperature, the least temperature, you can see it is around 16 to 18 degrees Celsius. So that can be the least temperature. So there is no sudden shift. During summers, the night temperature might be around 27 to 33 degrees Celsius. And during winters, the day temperature is 17 to 24 degrees Celsius, whereas night temperature is 16 to 18 degrees Celsius. So this is for the day and night during summer and winter. So we can see there is no much of diurnal change that might be experienced, maximum of, let's say, 12 degrees of diurnal change. So that happens. and humidity is, of course, it is very suitable. It is low in winter, and in summer it is higher, that maybe you can say 20 to 55 degrees Celsius. And monsoon, it also experiences higher humidity levels, that is around 50 to 90% or let's say 100%, sometimes few days it might be having 100% of humidity. Okay. Of few days or few weeks, it might exhibit humidity of 100% during monsoons. Okay. so we can also see that the humidity is usually low, that is when the temperature is less, and humidity is always relative in this way to the temperature. In other climatic zones also, if we study, then as the temperature rises, that is the, you can say, psychrometry, that is the relationship between the temperature and humidity. So as the temperature increases, you can increase the humidity levels also. Okay, as the temperature reduces, you can see there is a reduction in the humidity levels, especially the relative humidity. Okay. Precipitation is low. it is adequate, you can say it is low. It is not very high also, which is, you can say, around 600 mm per year, annual rainfall. And sky condition is mostly clear with occasional presence of low dense clouds during summers. Okay. And during, again, rainies, it might be, during monsoon, it might be showing some kind of sky cover. So that is maybe around 40% of sky cover, and otherwise it is almost clear. Okay. And solar radiation is also more or less same throughout the year. Okay. There is no, you can say, during monsoon it is having less radiation, but whereas other during winters or during summers, it is not having, it is having the same radiation. Wind velocity, so winds are generally high during, again, summer because of the heating and cooling of the atmosphere. Okay. So vegetation is fairly abundant. It is very favorable for vegetation or growth of any microorganisms and again these things. And it is also very much favorable for human habitation. Okay. For the normal working of human this thing. So it is very much favorable So with less effort or with less arrangements, you can achieve thermal comfort. That maybe you might have to cut summer sun, you need to hide summer sun, and you need to allow heating inside the building by allowing sunlight inside during winters. And you can have little arrangements to have some kind of ventilation with minimum windows and these things. You can achieve good comfort in this region. Okay. So cold and cloudy. Cold and cloudy, as the name itself indicates, it is a very cold climate which is having less temperature, and it is also having high humidity levels. So that is why it is considered as cold and cloudy. You can see the temperature during night. During summers, the maximum temperature goes around 30 degrees Celsius. That is for the daytime. And otherwise, winters, the day temperature is 17 to 27 degrees Celsius. And during summers, the temperature is 4 to 8 degrees Celsius, and sometimes it might go up to minus 3 to minus 4 degrees Celsius also. Okay, so that can be considered as very cold and a cloudy climate because of there are a lot of clouds, and also there is a lot of humidity in the atmosphere, that is 70 to 80% of humidity. Okay, some of these climates, let's say Mount Abu or some of these cold and cloudy in southern India, are basically because of the altitude. Okay. In Mount Abu is in Rajasthan, which is again considered as hot dry climate, but whereas Mount Abu is considered as cold climate because it is exhibiting these elements, it has these elements, or you can say these characteristics of cold and cloudy climate, and these are because of the altitude, that is the elevation from the mean sea level. And as we go higher, the temperature reduces, and there is also increased level of let's say relative humidity. Now, sky cover is overcast for most part of the year, except during brief summer. That summer is very short in these particular periods. So there is prolonged winters and brief summers. Okay, and solar radiation is low with a winter high percentage of diffuse radiation. Okay, because of the clouds, also because of the atmosphere. Okay, so wind velocity in this region experiences cold winds in the winter season. Okay. You can see the vegetation, you can see the landscape. So this is the landscape of, let's say, Ooty or some of the northern Himalayas. Even the animals are adapted themselves to this particular habitat. And there is a lot of tea, or there is this kind of vegetation. So vegetation is actually abundant during summer. And hundreds of species of moss, green, algae, lichens survive in harsh conditions of the polar biome. Okay. So special characteristics, you can say that it has long cold winters with annual temperature mostly below freezing. So that is might be around, sometimes it might experience let's say minus 3 or minus 4 degrees Celsius also. Soil is covered in ice, or there is dew formation which is quite regular. Even during summers or even during winters, there is dew formation, and some places it is also having snowfall or ice in this region. So this is some of the buildings that are, you can see, because of the snowfall or heavy rainfall. So there is, it is always having sloping roofs, and they use, sometimes they use dark colors to absorb a lot of heat. But there are a lot of glass that are used, or so that they can harvest a lot of sunlight inside the buildings. Here you can see they are trying to take a lot of light from the these things. And they try to keep all the windows and this thing. They use glass because there is no air movement, and they allow a lot of light. Okay, they want to trap a lot of heat inside, but they don't want to have air movement. That is again they get cold feeling, or they increases it reduces the temperature. So that is why they want more insulated. That is, they wanted to protect the heat inside the building. Okay. And they don't prefer to have mutual shading. They want more of harvesting sunlight. Okay, and even the landform is having a great topography. So that is why we can see the buildings. So I think this is Shimla, which is having a lot of buildings which are trying to take a lot of sunlight. Okay. So in India, composite climate, you can say composite is again the central part of India, which is again, you can say major part of India is experiencing composite. Now composite climate mainly has two types of climate that are composed together, you can say hot, dry and warm, humid. So it experiences hot, dry during summers and during rainfall or during monsoon seasons, it experiences warm, humid climate. And sometimes during winters also it experiences very cold winters. So that is why it is a combination of, let's say, three climatic characteristics. Okay, so that is why this is, it can be considered as the composite climate. Now, composite climate is experienced by majorly the central India, that is Madhya Pradesh, yes, some of the northern states of, let's say, Haryana, Punjab, Delhi, NCR, UP, Jharkhand. Okay, so these places also experiences this composite climate. Okay, so there are some of the cities like Delhi, Kanpur and all, so they also experiences composite climate. In even a part of let's say Gujarat also experiences composite climate. Okay, so here we can see the temperatures, which is 43 degrees Celsius, which is very hot, that is during summer. And during winters at night it can go up to 4 degrees Celsius, that is very low. So we can see the even the diurnal change is more, that is around 15 to 20 degrees Celsius of diurnal change. So that is why it is experiencing very hot and very cold climate. Okay. In terms of humidity also there are variations. During dry periods it experiences 20 to 25 degrees Celsius, 25% of relative humidity. And during wet periods, let's say monsoons, it experiences 55 to 95% of relative humidity. Okay. And the precipitation is also, it's fluctuating. Some year it might be around 500 mm per year, per annual rainfall, or it can have up to 1300 of annual rainfall. Okay, so it is based on the different climatic factors or global climatic factors, so that it can experience rains for different years. Okay, so we can say it is it has a and some places experiences actually 500 and some places experience, let's say 1300 mm of annual rainfall. So it is in this range we can classify them as composite climate. Okay, so you can see it is very hot during summer, very cold during winters. It is also exhibiting different humidity levels, right from 20 to 25% during dry periods, that is maybe let's say summers, and extreme of 95% during wet periods, that is during monsoons. Okay, so that is why it is considered as composite climate. Okay. So sky conditions, sky is overcast and dull in the monsoon and clear in the winter. So that is having both the characteristics, and radiation also very high in summer and diffuse radiation in monsoons because of the clouds that are formed. Wind velocity is strong during monsoons, that is southwest monsoon winds, and dry cold winds during summer. Okay, the winds from the other direction. Okay. So you can see the image which shows vegetation, which is again variable. So here there are again, you can say there is a drastic change in terms of climate, and there is a drastic change in terms of, this is not specifically for India, but this is exhibited in some other country where there is, during summer it is very green and during winter it is very dry and it is very brown. Okay. So during summers there is a lot of, again during monsoon or summers there is a lot of vegetation, but whereas winters there is a lot of dry vegetation. So this mainly there are a lot of deciduous trees which exhibit these kind of characters. Okay. So this is some of the buildings on the top left and top right are the images of Delhi, where they try to have, they try to overcome these extremes of climates, that is they are having overhangs, they are having sloping roof. They're also having jallies and also they're having this thing. So they want to protection during summers and winters and also. So this is again the left bottom corner and left right corner. right bottom corner and left bottom corner as for the Kanpur. where left bottom is again modern building, which is trying to protect from the extremes again. So this is on the right bottom corner is again a traditional building, or you can say vernacular building, where it is having archway and columnade and also some kind of arrangement so that it tries to cut the sunlight during the summers and it provides more thermal comfort. Even though it is extremely cold during, let's say during winters, but you can say majority of the year it experiences a lot of hot climate, okay, or you can say hot dry climate majority of the year. But whereas you can say 4 to 6 months it experiences hot and dry climate of dry climate, and some and again 3 months or 4 months of let's say humid, and also a very cold of let's say 2 to 3 months of very cold climatic seasons. Okay, so that is why it is considered as cold climate. Okay, so this was the lecture about the climatic zones of India, and what are the buildings, some of the examples of buildings that are built to have a controlled thermal comfort in this particular region. Thank you.